Sebastien Bourdais. We have Circuit of the Americas behind us. That sounds very European, doesn't it? We're here. We're on a Monday. There are no cars going around the track.
Hey, why are you here?
I have no life. I stalk you.
Like,
I don't know.
Like, that guy doesn't want to work extra shifts when there's stuff happening, but somehow he shows up on Monday. He's not there at the media day.
I'm leaving, actually, once we're done here. I don't know what you guys are doing
but
the next couple
days.
But
he's going to edit something that takes a huge amount of time just to talk shit, basically.
Basically.
That's amazing.
Well, folks say I'm amazing, not necessarily positive amazing. So what are we doing today? What are you doing today? Where have you been? It's 4 o'clock now, a little bit after. What have you been doing all day?
6 straight hours of talking about myself and...
So a normal day.
No, I'm not that self-centered, but yeah, just a lot of the media from the obviously all different promoters, IMS, IndyCar, you know, just every sponsors in the series, Firestone, and social content and everything, just doing media day basically.
So all the drivers, IndyCar drivers, have been downtown in a hotel. This is a normal part of spring training. Come in a day early, everybody gets all the questions they need. Did you get any interesting questions, anything fun or new that you've heard? You've been doing this a while.
I can't divulgate anything that's happened, but trust me, there'll be plenty of content that I'm not sure anybody wants to see.
Well,
it's certainly not me.
One of my
I'll just give you the highlight of the day. Simon sticking 29 pieces of candies, sour little rounds that thick around, 29 of them in his mouth, and they're like pure acid. That was the effort of the day.
Now, was this something that he did on a dare, or was this just him sitting in the corner
Simon Pagenaud things? No, that was people, I don't know, being creative, asking us to do stupid stuff, but it definitely was rather impressive.
I bet Seb could do 40.
Nope.
Tomorrow,
no,
on the Racers update.
I almost gagged and threw up at 18, but I was fine stopping right there.
All right, well, we won't then find out how many of whatever we can put in your mouth. So, Seb, the day as well, we have teams that have loaded in, and this is where I roll in some B-roll of me walking around showing various cars and teams. Everyone getting in, getting settled, doing whatever final bits are needed. Knowing that we were just in Monterey on Friday, it's just now Monday here in Texas, you think most teams actually still had a fairly sizable to-do list left over from Monterey?
Yeah, quite a bit. People might not know, but we're putting the first season engine in the car, so obviously quite a bit of work for the guys. You know, running Laguna, having to, you know, change a few things, change setups, set up flat pads and all sorts of things. And obviously for the truckies driving from California all the way to Austin, that's a day and an hour, I think, a 25-hour drive. So everybody has been pretty busy doing their part, but for sure the truckies have done their fair share. And, you know, just to get there and then back to business, 2 days of testing, Tuesday and Wednesday, and discovering a new track for me. So quite a few of us, I'm sure. So, slowly getting back in the groove. It smells like a new season again.
And you're going to go out and do a track walk here with everybody in about a half an hour. They open up the track for all teams to go and walk the place, learn it, look for any of the peculiarities. Big news of the day, though, this morning, unfortunately, Harding Steinbrenner Racing, Pato O'Ward, sending out an alert that he asked for a release from the team, and it was granted. It's a lot of backstory to all this. I wouldn't ask you to comment on that specifically, but have you ever been in a situation, or those close to you, where season's coming up and you have great plans, and for whatever reason, things come crumbling down, or you have to improvise?
The only time I've had anything like, you know, that kind of came to an end unexpectedly, and I've thankfully had an opportunity to rebound right away, was at the end of 11 when Peugeot stopped the works program with the 908. But thankfully I already had a full commitment in IndyCar with Jay, so that's never a good feel. And you know, for me at least, I learned about it through a friend who read the press release from Reuters, so that was like probably the worst way to learn about it. Mm-hmm. But for poor Pato, I mean, so much talent, and I really hate it for him. I mean, we started to hear bad rumors about that deal, and it's such a shame to see it come to reality. So hopefully, you know, the scholarship that he has graduating from Indy Lights, and he gets another chance with another team. But man, it's awful late to put something together. So really, really fingers crossed for him.
And that's maybe the biggest takeaway when I'm thinking long term. I was telling a friend here in the paddock a little while ago, I had a girlfriend once who told me, I don't know if I'm exactly what you want. And I was too young and insecure to take her at her word and say, you're right, let's split up. Stayed around way too long, and at the end realized I just lost too many months of my life when I should have realized better opportunities lie ahead. And I think that's going to be the case with Pato. It's going to be a rough short term. There's nothing that's going to come easy. We've heard rumors that there might be a short-term deal with Andretti, possibly. I know I sent him a couple of team owner contacts that might be interested in speaking with him. But not only have we been hearing about this for a while, Seb, I think to his benefit, this release probably could have been granted weeks ago and wasn't for whatever reason. The fact is, when someone says we're going to run you and they don't have the money to do so, you end up in this weird situation like this.
Yeah, I think, unfortunately, you see it a lot in racing. I mean, everybody's, you know, they got good intentions, but the problem is, when do you pull the plug and when do you make the call? And I think, you know, often a time you see those scenarios unfold and everybody's trying really hard to make it happen, and they kind of lose sight of reality and what's really lying ahead. And you know, I mean, you can be frustrated, you can do whatever, but at the end of the day, I think everybody means good. That's just, yeah, there's a lack of realism, you know, into the whole thing, and it's just a shame when it you know, affects a young driver that showed so much promise. I think
I'm going to pass around the hat here. This guy has like tens of millions socked away from his Champ Car years. He could put in a million easy, wouldn't even notice it was gone. Miller's not going to be here this weekend, by the way. He's got strep throat, so with the weather being what it is, that's not a bad thing. So I think it's just going to be the two of us. No.
Are we doing this all week?
Cool. Yeah. Now I'm going to need you to come off track about halfway through the final session on Wednesday.
I'll let you have that conversation with Craig Emerson.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. All right. Well, this is the French Run Hamburger Show from Circuit of the Americas on Monday. We'll be back tomorrow when you're actually making noise and going fast.
Sounds good.
Don't hit anything.
Okay.